We are a family. We are a brotherhood. Tonight, for the next 10 nights, do it for one thing, for each other. Time to shine, man.
Welcome, Spartan fans, to episode 2 of Grind to Shine, a season with Alexander football. I'm Nathan Wiseman, joined by Patrick Klinger. The Alexander Spartans started off the 2016 campaign with a dominant 39-0 victory over Federal Hocking, meaning that Spacer's trophy stays right here in Albany.
Yeah, the win was a team effort, but was headlined by senior A.J. Marks, who totaled 3 touchdowns and 2 interceptions, all in the first half. So let's take a look back at how the Spartans improved to 1-0.
These Spartan seniors are used to seeing this Spacer trophy in the locker room, and they're not ready to give it away just yet. Senior A.J. Marks picking Dylan Wilfong's pass off and taking it 40 yards to the house for a pick six, giving these Spartans the early to 6-0 lead.
Yeah, Nathan, these seniors have to make big plays in games like this, and Marks was just getting started. He bounces to the outside and takes the ball 50 yards down the sideline, all the way down to the 12-yard line, and Coach Penrod knows the senior got him all the way down there, so he gives him the go-ahead to punch it into the end zone. 14-0 Spartans early on in the first quarter, and Marks still making big plays. Wilfong rolls out to pass, and the ball hawk. Marks gets another interception, giving the Spartans the ball back.
Yeah, we've seen plenty of A.J. Marks plays. How about the other stud of the Spartan offense, Mr. Chase Harris, finding a lot of open room down the right side of the field, and then 3 plays later, he is just going to walk this one right in for a 4-yard touchdown, giving these Spartans the 20-0 lead. Federal Hocking really controlled the clock the majority of the second quarter. 4th and 2 here, Ethan Howes will put an end to that drive, giving the Spartans ball right back.
Yeah, and that's just the story of the game, Nathan. This Alexander defense just so strong all night long, and it didn't take the Spartans very long to get back in the end zone as A.J. Marks busts off a 77-yard score. He finished the game with 7 carries, 211 all-purpose yards, and 3 scores. What a game for that young man. And the Spartans went into the locker room with a 27-0 lead at halftime and came out of the third quarter with just as much intensity. Chase Harris with the read option, 59 yards for the score, 33-0 Spartans. That just about put the game away.
Yes, 2 dominant guys controlling this game, A.J. Marks and Chase Harris, but they got a well-deserved break near the end of this one. So sophomore quarterback Ryan Marks took a few lessons from his older brother, takes this one in for a 4-yard touchdown.
Yeah, the Spartans get the shutout and the win, improving to 1-0 on the season.
All right, Coach, so everything that your team, you and your team have done over this offseason was leading up to that first week of football, and now that it's come and gone and got that big win, you know, what does it feel like to get that first win out of the way and over and done with?
It's always nice just to get to week one and get that first one definitely over. Just scrimmages can only do so much. I mean, the big thing, I mean, you want to see things, you want to improve on things, but everybody wants to just talk about get out healthy. So we were fortunate enough to get out healthy. Then week one comes and we get out healthy again. But we really see a lot of just positives just up front. I thought we did a tremendous job both sides of the football. We got our young guys, our freshmen, really some good game experience, and our juniors and seniors that don't have that varsity experience finally got some, and under Friday or Thursday night lights. So just that transition was exciting to see, and now we know that true grind of our schedule is really going to come with 2 playoff teams from the previous year, and then week 4 we got Athens. So it doesn't get any easier, but it was really positive to see a lot of growth.
Yeah, and after you put in all that work on the field, the lights are shining, you get that win on the scoreboard, what's it like to go into the locker room with the guys and just celebrate after a big win like that?
Really, I mean, singing that alma mater to our band in front of all of our home stands, and then we run over and ring that victory bell. I mean, that's where it starts to sink in that you just did what you set out to do. Then talking to the guys for a couple minutes, it's exciting, but most of those Friday nights you get to stick around and enjoy a little bit, but unfortunately we had school the next day, so it wasn't too much enjoyment, but tried to get some sleep there Thursday night, but I have to watch that game film and watch it a couple times, and so it was a late night and an early morning.
Yeah, speaking of those guys singing, you got some real some guys going out for American Idol.
Well, that's why I try to stay away from when they're singing.
And special guest out up in the stands for the first time. Little Gemma got to see her first Alexander Spartans game. So, you know, how cool was it for you to know that your daughter was watching from the sideline?
Oh, it was definitely special, and I kept on trying to look back and find her, and finally was able to spot her. And definitely peeked back there a couple times, but you also had to try to stay focused there during the game. But that was what was neat about having that comfortable halftime lead is we're trying to talk about just a couple things that we want to do in there. And one of the kids tells me that my wife and daughter are out there. So that was pretty cool to be able to hold her there at halftime and be able to see my family.
Definitely. And this question actually comes from Joe Marks. He wants to know, you know, what's one of the most difficult play calls that you have to give to your offense? I mean, you know, they're always running. I always hear you yelling rocket, laser, arrow, all this stuff, and it gets pretty lengthy. So can you rattle off maybe one of the more complex play calls?
Well, thankfully, the verbiage is a whole lot easier than the actual signals, and I think that's why I retired that and designated that to Coach Russell there. But it's probably more simple than what people think, really. I mean, I don't want to get too much verbiage, but really, when it's the hand signals and kids really putting all that together and putting it into their head. So that's, I guess, probably the most difficult thing is, but it's just one of those preach by habit type things, and kids just understand really what the signal is, probably more than actual word of things.
Yeah, I mean, he always wonders how AJ can remember all of those things, and that's understandable. We've been around since June, and I still don't even know what in the world's going on. But
we can go say rip rocket, Toledo, watch, arrow, backside slant, T arrow. I mean, so it's a lot going on, then the line will have a different call and different language to things. So it can probably get a little complicated at times, but the kids do a tremendous thing. And we really, we install it in June, and everything that we do in practice, we use that verbiage and use those signals. So just it comes just as natural.
Yeah, absolutely. And switching directions a little bit, I don't think anybody would refute your success on the field as a coach, but talk off the field a little bit. Got a fantasy football draft coming up pretty soon. If you had the first pick, your ideal first pick, who would you pick, and why would you pick him?
Tom Brady, because he's the best, and he's going to put up numbers. He's got great pieces around him. Everybody knows Gronk, but the big piece people probably don't know about that's going to help him out is old Martellius Bennett there at tight end.
What, so even with the suspension, you still want to pick him first?
Without a doubt. I'm a Patriots man. Bill Belichick.
With this week coming up, you got Chesapeake this week, and that is the only team that beat you in the regular season a season ago. So just how badly do you want to get a win this week?
Not just because we had lost to him last year. Just it's the next opponent, and it's our next school, and this week's school is 1-0, and we know what it's going to have to take to beat them. And it's obviously getting better this week in practice and taking care of the football, continually getting better up front, and our young guys continually get growth. So it's a lot of little things, but as far as losing to them last year, it might be a little something that we can throw in there, but that can only take you so far.
Yeah, we'll see how it plays out on Friday night. Coach, thanks a lot.
Hey, thanks, Pat.
I highly approve of Coach Penrod's pick of choosing Tom Brady in the first round of that fantasy draft. And speaking of the NFL, the new Madden 17 game came out this week, so I decided to put senior James Wallace on the hot seat and challenge him to a friendly game of Madden.
So I gotta go with my team, the Patriots. But what's your favorite team? What are you going with?
Definitely the Packers.
Packers. Why the Packers? Why is that your favorite team?
Because, like, when I was a little kid, my favorite color was green. And, of course, green is in their name, Green Bay Packers, so I automatically had to pick them.
All right, good enough reason.
It's Aaron Rodgers going up against Tom Brady.
Again, they'll throw with Rodgers.
Oh! Here we go.
How much of a confidence booster was that win now, heading into the rest of the season?
I feel like it's actually pretty big for us, seeing that all the young people we have on our team getting the win probably has them boosted up for the next game, seeing that we can win a game, we have a chance, we can go out there and dominate on the field.
There we are. Not Gronk, but I'll take it. So I don't know if you know this, but Coach Penrod, in an old Madden game, made the 2016 Alexander Spartans. He has a team. and it's the Falcons because of the colors, the red and white. But he says he hasn't updated the ratings yet. So when he does, what do you think your Madden score should be? This is a tough one.
I'd probably be about average person, so about 79, 80, 81-ish.
You got to go at least the high 80s. Give yourself a little bit of credit.
See, I don't feel like that. You got to be humble.
And again, it's Rodgers.
Oh,
yes.
You know, in addition to football, you have a pretty big passion for wrestling as well. So how long have you been wrestling?
Well, I wrestled in kindergarten, and then up until seventh grade is when I took a break for a year. Missed it so much, wanted to come back, but I couldn't. So then eighth grade, I came back out, and now I've wrestled ever since. Love the sport, just love what it has done for me as a person and just as an athlete.
Now, I heard you talking one day about how, you know, your mom makes the best food for the team,
gosh.
And your dad, you know, is kind of like the team dad. How special is that for you?
It kind of gives us this bond of always being part of the sports and being like the family of them. People love my mom. People love my dad. They'll go up and give my, they'll call my dad their dad sometimes and just joke around with them. And they just love my mom's food. They'll always go up and give her hugs and always ask for seconds. There's a people on the wrestling team. We had like four people on the wrestling team ask my mom just to make them personal pants of bread pudding.
I would take some of that.
Now Rodgers throwing on second down.
Dalbert, where are you? I need you, man.
We need Coach Dalbert here.
They'll go for it. It's Rodgers. Rolling to his right.
Come on, Aaron. Yes. You gotta get rid of that.
Safety position now more than ever is a hybrid type player.
I hear you never open a book. So how do you get so many good grades if you don't open the book? Man, that's crazy.
It just comes naturally to me.
Yeah.
So it's, I don't know. I just.
It's just right up there.
Basically, it just comes easy for me. And
is it like that with football too? Because playing offense and defense, that's got to get complicated with some of the different plays and everything. Does that just kind of come naturally as well?
It does. During practice, I pay attention to what coach is saying. I watch what the plays were doing. I study them. I get them memorized. That way, I'm able to know what I'm supposed to be doing at all times. And I'm not out there on the field messing up on something as simple as a run that we're doing or a pass route. That way, I can be able to help out the team as much as possible.
What was it like growing up with so many brothers and sisters? Do you have any like backyard football games, or did things get intense?
We played football and stuff, but always being the younger brother, I was like the one that always got picked on or messed with because I was always the youngest by like a couple years or something. But we'd go out there, play two-and-touch football and stuff. We'd go throw football around or just hang out, play basketball, play like pig or something.
Wanted to challenge it, so he's probably going to send a New York
off. Blitz the wrong gap.
You didn't have the energy and effort, James. I'm sorry.
I know.
You didn't have the...
Sorry, Coach P, I let you down.
Two things, energy and effort.
You don't need talent to control those.
That's right.
Here's Rodgers.
Oh!
It's caught.
On the board.
Touchdown.
See, if I was able to focus the rest of the game, who knows what the score could be.
James, 23-8, man. What happened?
You guys kept asking me questions. I wasn't focused.
Excuses.
I wasn't focused. That last drive I had, I was focused. I was determined to score. And what happened?
Mm-hmm.
I marched it down the field, and I scored on you.
Excuses, James. Hey, we're going to have to schedule a rematch here soon.
Anytime.
I still can't believe Nathan actually won that game, but I'm definitely taking James in the rematch. And now one of the big moments leading up to week one was the announcement of the team's captains. It's more than just going out for a coin toss for these young men. So let's take a look inside what it means to these four seniors.
After that first play, it's time to get going. Time to do this thing. You guys lead the way. Emotionally, physically, how you set the tone leads with you guys right here. You guys are captains for a reason, because they look up to you. Good, bad, you dictate everything. Your body language, your emotion, everything that you say, their eyes are on you.
Despite a young Alexander team, the Spartans are driven by their newly named team captains, AJ Marks,
Chase Harris, Brandon Wilkinson, and Alex Stalder. Each of them ready to embrace the role of a leader.
I was super excited and I was super grateful because, I mean, there's a lot of guys who could have been a captain who were well qualified, and I was one of the guys to be chosen. I was very grateful and I was really happy because I worked hard to become a captain.
With the pride that we have in our program, it just means a lot to be able to know that I was selected out of the however many kids we have to be able to lead the team. And I just think it shows that that's what the coaches want and that's the kind of example that they want to set.
Becoming a captain was no walk in the park. Instead of being judged by their performance on the field, every applicant was treated as if they were applying for a job.
It's more about preparing them for life after football. They go through the application process, have to make a cover letter. We review them and we bring them on for interviews, schedule interviews. They dress up like they would for a job interview, come in to the coaches and sit down and we ask, grill them with questions. Just kind of preparing them for life after football.
I was kind of nervous just because it's a role that I've wanted since I was a little kid, and it's a role that I think I would succeed at, and I think I just wanted to better the team.
It was a little bit of nervousness because, I mean, you really want to get that captain role and you don't want to say anything that would just make them be done with you right off the bat. So you're trying to, it's almost like they're not your coaches anymore. It's almost like you don't know them. You're really nervous and you don't know what they're going to ask and what's going to happen.
While some may shy away from the spotlight, these seniors are using their platform to help their teammates.
A lot of things rush through my head. I'm like, sweet, this is awesome. I get this honor and privilege. But at the same time, it was like, okay, responsibility is on me now. And I gotta bring it every day. I gotta be 100% every day and show these guys exactly what it means to play Spartan football.
If you see somebody doing something wrong, you just gotta point it out. Not necessarily confront and be all up in their grill about it, but you gotta let them know what they're doing wrong and try to help them fix it.
I feel like it says a lot about who I am and how hard I'm willing to work. And the whole time I was hurt, I was just trying to better myself as being a vocal leader, and I did that.
I'm always trying to be the last guy, and not necessarily just to be the last guy in the locker room and get that staple of, oh, he's staying late. I'm trying to help out guys that need help. I'm trying to make sure everything's cleaned up, making sure everything's ready for the next day at practice. That way we're not confused. That way we can get out there and get moving as fast as possible.
Along with their accomplishments on Friday nights, the 2016 captains are preparing for much more.
They're going to go far in life, whether it's with college athletics or whether it's just going for a job here in a couple years. They're going to succeed in everything they do.
I think the only place to go from here is up. We've got a lot of good guys. We've got a lot of good guys working hard. And the captains that we put in place have always worked hard, have always taught the other guys what to do, and bring a lot of energy to the table. So the only place I see us going is up.
Week one is coming on, so it's time to break down week number two. Alexander welcoming Chesapeake to town this week. This is a huge matchup for the Spartans because Chesapeake was the only team to beat the Spartans in the regular season last year.
That's right, last season, week number two, Alexander traveled to Chesapeake and got edged out 9-3 in a close matchup. And Nathan, this season it's going to be a very good game to watch. Chesapeake brings to town that wing T offense led by senior quarterback Casey McComas, and this offense is very confusing. A lot of fakes, a lot of motion, a lot going on. This offense is averaging 7 yards per pass and per run, so they're really moving the football, and this Alexander defense is really going to have to be disciplined and ready to go this week.
It's going to be interesting to see what Coach Saunders has schemed up to defend that wing T offense on Friday night. So Pat and I are going to break down three keys to an Alexander win on Friday night. And our first point is that we think a third guy really needs to step up for these Spartans. Chase Harris had 2 touchdowns the other night. AJ Marks had 3. I think a guy like Connor Kimbrough could do that. He's speedy, he's shifty, he could get open. So I think that he could make some big plays for him on Friday night.
Kimbrough certainly will be one to watch it. And that's not to say that Marks and Harris can't have a great game. They're going to have to play very well for this Alexander team to be in contention in this game. But yeah, like you said, Kimbrough, maybe sophomore Ethan Howes, but Michael Kelly, Alex Stalder, someone on the offensive end is going to have to make some big plays alongside Marks and Harrison. And defensively, they're going to have guys step up as well, because Chesapeake is going to be one of the tougher opponents that the Spartans face all season long.
Yeah, and another key for this game is Alexander is going to have to win the turnover battle. They played a clean game last Thursday night against Federal Hocking. AJ didn't throw any interceptions, and he picked off 2 of Federal Hocking's passes. They're going to need to have another big game like that, making no offensive mistakes and making some key defensive plays in order to get this win.
That's right, and Alexander and Chesapeake were similar last week, and that both teams teams created turnovers and on the defensive end put some points on the board. So they're gonna, Alexander is going to have to win that turnover battle. It's crucial in any game, but this one specifically, Nathan, I think if they do win the turnover battle, they will give themselves a very good chance to stay in this game.
It's those little things to get the W. And speaking of not playing sloppy, extra points was not a strong suit for the Alexander Spartans last week.
They had
three fumbles. I know that Brendan Niggemeier is a new kicker for this team, but three fumbles for the special teams unit is just not acceptable. It's not going to get it done on Friday night.
Yeah, and it's a game of inches, and those inches add up throughout the game. So, Nathan, they're going to have to get those extra points down if they're going to have a chance here. I mean, it could be 1, 2, 3 points could really make the difference between a win and a loss here in week two. So they're going to have to clean that up and be ready to go Friday.
Definitely. So Alexander blew out Federal Hocking last week. Chesapeake blew out Oak Hill last week. I just don't think this is going to be a blowout. I think this is going to be a close game.
I think so. I think the fans are going to be in for a treat Friday night. I know that we're excited.
Should be fun.
Yeah, exactly. So we will see you guys there Friday, and we put together a little something to get you guys ready for that game at 7:30 on Friday. So here you go.
Red Bull in my hands, feels like I got wings. Lot of people in my face, but I can't hear a thing. It's like my head's up in the clouds, heads up in the clouds, and I ain't coming down, no. Just turn the music on, just let me get lost. I swear that I'ma lose it if somebody turns it off. What are you, out your mind? You must be out your mind. Just turn the music on. Turn the music out!
And that'll do it for this episode of Grind to Shine, a season with Alexander football. And remember, you can follow along with us all week long through our Spartan End Zone YouTube channel, Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram accounts.
Yeah, we want to hear from you, the Spartan fans, so be sure to tweet at us or mention us on Facebook before and after the Chesapeake game on Friday night. We would love to talk some Spartan football with you.
And don't miss our next episode, September 8th, where we will be back at Penrod's place to break down the Chesapeake game and preview the matchup with Scioto Ville East. So until then, thanks for watching, and we'll see you next time.